This is the YGTV News.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Monday the 10th of June. I'm Giordano Durante. Maroua Kharbouch crowned Miss Gib. Albert Isola set to stand for the GSLP at the by-election. Feetham regrets lack of united front at the UN. The GSD says government is not being open regarding number six companies. And finally, new police authority chairman. This weekend's 51st Miss Gibraltar show, carried out at the John McIntosh Hall for the first time in history, was won by public favourite contestant number one, 22-year-old Maroua Kharbouch. Winning the positions of second and first princesses were Stacey Brito and Jamie Lee Randall. The show was produced by Stage One and presented by James Niche and Sky News presenter Paula Middlehurst, with performances from local musicians This Side Up, Holly Buaja and Chloe Martinez, as well as La Voz finalist Micah. YGTV caught up with Maroua this afternoon to reflect back on the experience and how it felt to win.
Maroua, first of all, congratulations on your win. Tell us a little bit about the experience as a whole and what you've taken away from it.
Oh, the experience, it was a fantastic journey, it was phenomenal. I would honestly recommend it to anybody. It's been a roller coaster of a ride. And I'm going to take away with it lasting friendships, I think, is the main thing. And a whole new aspect of myself. I just can't believe, you know, when you put your mind to something, what you can achieve. It's been incredible.
Excellent. And how are you feeling at the time that your name was called during Saturday night's show? And reflecting back on it, how are you feeling now? Is it any different?
It's a little bit different. Looking back, I honestly was in disbelief. I could not imagine. I couldn't believe it. It was very unreal. And now, I guess it's sinking in a little bit because I've been so busy today. It's sort of, people have been forcing me to sort of get really used to the idea, you know. I've been having interviews all day, etc. But I've seen Mr. Walters in the past, and to me, they've always been, you know, tall, beautiful, elegant women, and now, you know, I'm one of them too, which is fantastic because now younger girls can look up to me and think, see, wow, another tall, elegant, beautiful woman, but who also has a beautiful personality on the inside as well, which is what I want to try to gain from this as well.
The lawyer and former GSLP House of Assembly member Albert Isola has been selected by the Executive Committee of the GSLP to stand as a candidate in next month's by-election. The decision still needs to be approved by the party's membership at a meeting later on this evening. Mr. Isola, who was a member of the then GSLP opposition between 1996 and 2000, was one of six candidates considered by the party's executive. Mr. Isola will face the GSD's Marlene Naon and the PDP's Nick Cruz in a vote on July the 4th to fill the seat vacated after the death of Charles Blusson. Daniel Feetham, the leader of the opposition, has expressed his regret that Gibraltar will not present a united front in the forthcoming address to the UN Special Committee on Decolonization later this week. Although the GSD's view is that Gibraltar's relationship with the United Kingdom is non-colonial, Mr. Feetham has expressed a desire to join Mr. Picardo at the UN, provided, he says, they can agree on the content of a joint address. In an interview given in April for YGTV, Mr. Feetham said this would ensure that the contribution represents Gibraltar rather than the views of Mr. Picardo, with the opposition relegated to what he terms a supportive role. This is Mr. Feetham speaking to us a few months ago.
Look, I hope to be able to sit down with Mr. Picardo in the near future and perhaps be able, as a matter of realpolitik, and as a matter of presenting a united front, a united Gibraltar front, not as a matter of intellectually, you know, the intellectual position of it, which I've just described, which is that as a matter of fact, we're not a colony, we're not, you know, conceding of that, but as a matter of presenting a united front, I might be persuadable to attend the United Nations with Mr. Picardo on a joint front.
The GSD has said that the recent government explanations in the press and in Parliament in relation to the number six registered companies give rise to more questions than they provide answers, and that this addresses the opposition's suspicion that the government has been caught out. The GSD explains its concerns in relation to these companies and says that the detail of the policy had not been announced prior to the GSD raising the issue. Damon Bossino for the GSD said that the opposition continues to be concerned at the serious issues of good governance which have been raised since the opposition's exposure of ETB1 Limited and the other government-registered companies, and urges the government to provide all the details of the supposed scheme or at least reconsider it in its entirety. And finally, John Gonsalves has been appointed as the new chairman of the police authority. Mr. Gonsalves has been a member of the Gibraltar Sports Advisory Committee since 1972, president of the Gibraltar Amateur Basketball Association since 1984, and is currently vice president of the European Basketball Federation. He replaces Richard Garcia, who was thanked for all his work as chairman of the authority, which acts as an essential element of the constitutional architecture as it ensures the operational independence of the RGP. That's YGTV News. We're back tomorrow evening. See you then.